All right, now to demonstrate how to calculate payback when the cash flows are not the same amount each year, but when they differ each year. We call it uneven cash flows. Still pretty simple. Here's an example. We'll go through an example. The cost of the potential project or asset is $5,000, has a six-year life, and that the project is generated, is anticipated to generate net cash inflows. So that would be cash coming in minus cash going out to get to net cash flows each year. And in year, so N is used to designate the year. So year 1 through 6, the net cash flows in each year are in the column here. So $1,000 net will come in at the end, by the end of year 1, during and by the end of year 1, $1,500 in year 2. That's what this project of $5,000 generates, these net cash inflows. So how long will it take to achieve payback period? Simply, you add up the cash flows until they equal the initial cost of the project. And we make a column called cumulative cash flow. So at the end of year 1, we get $1,000 in, so cumulative cash flow is $1,000. By the end of year 2, we get another $1,500. So our cumulative cash flow then is $1,000 plus $1,500, so $2,500 cumulative. Are we up to our $5,000 yet? Cost? Nope. The next year, year 3, we get an additional $1,500 net in from this project. So then we're up to $2,500 plus $1,500. We're up to net cash in of $4,000 by the end of year 3. Are we to our $5,000? Not quite yet, but getting close. So we can see that the next year, year 4, we generate $1,200 of net cash in. We don't need quite that much. We want to get to $5,000. Net cash in, because that's the initial cost. So far, we're at 4,000. So we just need a portion of year 4, right? Our year 4's cash flows. By this point, we've recouped $4,000. We just need a portion of year 4's cash flows. And that portion is, how much of this year's cash flows do we need? Well, we need 1,000. We don't want 5,000, that's the initial cost. We're already at 4,000, so we need $1,000 out of year 4's cash flow of $1,200, and that gives us a ratio of 0.833 of a year, right? So we've achieved payback in 3 years plus 0.833 of a year, right, of year 4. So we can see we've achieved payback in 3.83 years. All right, and you can turn that into months if you want to as well. That's return of investment, right? By just less than 4 years, we've completely recouped the company's initial $5,000 investment. Return of investment. It's not till the end of the fourth year, and then in years 5 and year 6, where we actually have return on investment. And you can figure that out for each year as well. $700 in year 5 divided by initial cost of $5,000. That would be return on investment for year 5. And then $400 in year 6 divided by initial investment. That would be the return on investment in year 6. And then the project is done. It's a six-year life. So to recap payback, simply add up the cash flows until they equal the initial cost of the project. It's simple. And as you can imagine, a shorter payback is better. We want as short of a payback as possible. Companies often now are requiring 2 years or less, or even sometimes 1 year or less payback period before they will invest in a large project. Thank you.